Today we're going to start reviewing conversions between fractions, decimals, and percents. So in our booklet here, make sure you write your name and your class period. When we open it up, you can write about yourself. Here is our table of contents. So first we're going to talk about converting decimals and percents to fractions. Then we're going to talk about converting fractions to decimals and percents. Then percents to decimal and fractions, and then finally some common conversions. So we're going to start here, chapter one, converting decimals and percents to fractions. So hopefully some of this is reviewed, but if it's not, then this should help. When we are going to convert a decimal to a fraction, we need to make sure that we read the decimal place value. Okay, and some of you have already done this in class, and so you're quite good at it. And when we say that, remember we have the tens place, we have the ones place, and after our decimal, we have the tenths, the hundredths, the thousandths, and so on. So we need to make sure that we read it correctly, and we're going to practice that. So after we've done that, then we're going to write the related fraction, meaning write it how you said it, and then always, since we are writing a fraction, we will simplify if needed. So an example of this would be if I gave you decimal 3.5. Well, that's not actually how we say this. We say this 35, if we look at our place value here, if I put the 3 here and the 5 here, this would be 35/100. So we're going to write it as we say it. And we know that this is in 5 and 0, so back to our division rule, we know that these both reduce by 5. 4/7/20. So 35/100 is written as a fraction 7/20. We can also do this with whole numbers, or I'm sorry, mixed numbers. 6.3 is said 6 wholes, and we say this 3/10. You know that 3/10 does not simplify, so we say this as 6 3/10, which we can also write as a fraction. We can do the same thing with negatives. I wrote -0.625. Again, that's not the correct way to say it. We make sure we keep our negative. 625. The 5 is in the thousandth place. So I will write 625/1,000. Well, I know that if I think of quarters and I think of money, I know I can simplify this by 25. So when I do that, don't forget to bring your negative. There are 25 quarters and $6.25. There are 40 quarters and $10, but that still reduces more. This ends in 5 and 0. So I know 5 is in both of these. Don't forget your negative. 5 goes into a negative 25 negative 5 times, and 5 goes into 40 8 times. So a negative 5/8, and this is one that we are going to end up memorizing. We turn the page. We can talk about converting a percent to a fraction, and all of y'all have already told me that you know that percent means out of 100. So this is actually quite simple. So we simply need to write the percent number over 100, and then of course simplify if needed. So let's try that. So if I gave you the example of 17%, I know that means that I have 17 out of 100. That does not simplify. 17 is a prime number. So we are done. But what if I gave you 60%? Well, I can write 60 over 100. I know I can cross out those zeros for 6/10, which also simplifies by 2. 2 goes into 6, 3 times 2 goes into 10, 5 times. We can also do this with decimal percentages. Percentages do not have to be a whole number. We can write 37.5%. Well, let's write that over 100. Now, this gets a little funky because we do have a decimal, but we can go ahead and we can change that. Well, I know if I multiply this by 2, I will get rid of that decimal. So we're going to kind of make it bigger in order to make it smaller. So I know 2 times 100 is 200. 2 times 37.5 is 75. And now this is a whole lot easier to simplify because we don't have a decimal. Again, think of quarters. I can take and divide both of these by 25 to simplify it. And when I do that, I have 3/4 in 75 cents, and I have 8/4 in $2. So 37.5% is equivalent to 3/8. On our next page, we're going to convert fractions to decimal then percent. And we've actually done some of this to convert a fraction to a decimal. We've done this. We did cowboy horse. So we are simply going to divide the numerator, the cowboy, by the denominator, the horse. The result, and in this case, we're not going to change it to a fraction remainder, okay? So we can add a zero. And we will get a terminating, which means it stops, or a repeating decimal. And if it stops, if it terminates, then that means that it will be done. If it repeats, we're going to have to use bar notation to make that happen. Now, I'm going to show you both of those methods with examples on this next slide. So we'll start with 5/8. Again, cowboy horse, so 8 goes outside and 5 goes inside. I'm going to go ahead and add my decimal because 5 is a whole number. So the decimal is at the back. I can put zeros, like $5. 8 does not go into 5, but 8 goes into 50 6 times. With 2 left over, I'm going to bring down my zero. 8 goes into 20 2 times. With 4 left over, I need to add one more zero here. 8 goes into 40 5 times. And this is, again, what we call a terminating decimal. So I can write 5/8 is equal to, if we say this correctly as we talked about before, 625,000. This is an example of a terminating decimal because it stops. If I gave you 7/9, again, cowboy horse, go ahead and bring up your decimal. 9 does not go into 7, but 9 goes into 70, 7 times, which is 63. Subtract, bring down the 0. I have 70 again, so 7, 63. And you can see that this pattern is just going to continue. So when it's going to continue, we use what is called bar notation. And that is that we put a bar or a line over the part that repeats. And what that's saying is that this is going to be 0.77777 forever and ever and ever. And this is an example of a repeating decimal. Now, sometimes we have, you know, it'll be a pattern, 0.737373. Then we would write 7 and 3 and put the bar over both. To convert a fraction to a percent, we're going to convert, do two things. You're going to first convert the decimal, or I'm sorry, convert the denominator to 100, because percent means out of 100. If possible, now this is not always a possible thing, but if you can, then do that. And if you can, then you're going to convert the numerator to the equivalent number out of 100. The numerator will be your percent. So this is essentially like when we find a common denominator. I'm going to go ahead and show you an example of that first one over here. So if I give you 4/5, we need to say this needs to be out of 100, right? And this is going to be our percent up here. Well, it's just like when we find a common denominator, 5 times what is 100? 20. And what I do to the bottom, I have to do to the top. Well, 4 times 20 is 80. So that means that 4/5 is equal to 80%. Now, sometimes it doesn't work out super pretty like that. If it doesn't work out really pretty like that, then your other method is going to have two steps. You're going to convert the fraction to a decimal, which we just talked about on the previous page, using your cowboy horse. Then, you're going to multiply the decimal by 100 to get the percent. Because again, percent means out of 100. The shortcut for that is to move two places to the right with the decimal. I'm going to show you an example of that. So sometimes, again, it doesn't work out super pretty. So if I gave you 1/3, well, we can't, there's nothing times 3 to get to 100, not a whole number anyway. So we can say 3 into 1 decimal, bring it up, and put some zeros. 3 does not go into 1. 3 goes into 10 3 times, that's 9. 1, bring down the 0. And you can see this is going to be a repeating decimal. So I'm going to go ahead and write 0.3, we have to use that bar notation. Now, I'm going to take, percent means out of 100, so I need to take my decimal times 100, which will give us 33.3%.